So in the last class we discussed that if there are two vectors A and B having angle theta between them, okay, so we saw that if we complete this parallelogram by making parallel sides to these vectors, okay, then the diagonal of this parallelogram gave us the resultant of these two vectors, okay. So I wanted to tell you one more thing in the last lecture, but I forgot, was that if this angle theta is 90 degrees, B vector is perpendicular to the A vector, okay. Now we finish this parallelogram, okay. This will be a rectangle and this will be your resultant vector, okay. So in this case we call A vector and B vector are rectangular components of vector R. All right. So A and B are the rectangular components of vector R, and they can be written as, if this angle is phi, so you will be able to write that magnitude of the vector A can be written as magnitude of R into cos phi, and the magnitude of vector B can be written as magnitude of vector R into sin phi. Okay, so we start off with a simple question. So there are two forces acting at a point, okay, their magnitudes are given to us and their directions are also shown here, okay. So we have to find the resultant of these two forces, alright. So the directions are given in the question, so we have to find the magnitude and the direction of the resultant force and write them according to these directions, okay. So this 100 Newton force is in the south direction and this 120 Newton force is 30 degrees north of east, okay. So when we go from east to north and we cover 30 degrees, we will be in the direction of this force, okay. So we can say it is in the direction 30 degrees north of east, okay. And this is how we will write the resultant vector as well, okay. So let's solve this problem, okay. So let's take a coordinate system. So x-axis is in the east-west direction and y-axis is in the north-south direction. So if the resultant of these two forces makes angle phi with the x-axis, okay, so its rectangular components will be Rx I kya and Ry j kya. This will be Rx, this will be Ry, okay. So Rx will be magnitude of R times cos phi and Ry will be magnitude of R times sin phi, alright. So now these two forces are acting at a point, and at this point we have summation of fx will be equal to rx and summation of fy will be equal to ry, alright. So we calculate this first. So summation of fx equals to rx gives us the equation 120 cos 30 degree should be equal to Rx, and the second equation gives us 120 sin 30 minus 100 is equals to Ry, right. So Rx we have calculated is nothing but magnitude of R cos phi, and Ry is magnitude of R sin phi. Okay, we can get the magnitude of vector R by squaring and adding these equations up. Okay, so we'll do that. So we obtain R square and cos square phi plus sin square phi goes to 1 equals to 120 cos 30 is nothing but root 3 by 2. Okay, this whole square plus 120 sin 30 is 1 by 2 minus 100 whole square. Okay, from here you obtain magnitude of R as 111 newtons. Alright, so to calculate the angle phi, you divide this equation by this equation, so you will get tan phi will be equal to 120 1 by 2 minus 100 divided by 120 root 3 by 2. Alright, so you calculate this and phi will be obtained as roughly 339 degrees. Okay, so the resultant vector would be somewhat like this. Alright, and this will be 339 degrees, so this will be 21 degrees. Alright, so the direction of R vector is 21 degrees south of east. Okay, so this will be the direction. Alright, one more way to do it is by the triangle law. So now we do this question by triangle law. So we place these two vectors such that the head of one vector is placed at the tail of the other vector. Okay, so we draw the vector of magnitude 120 newton like this and vector of 100 newton magnitude like this. So our resultant would be something like this. Okay, this will be our resultant. Alright, if the resultant makes angle alpha, okay, with the 100 newton force, then we can say these angles will be, this will be alpha. Okay, and the 120 newton force and 100 newton force have the angle 60 degree between them. Okay, so this will be 60 degrees. Okay, so now you can easily calculate from the law of sines. Okay, that magnitude of R vector divided by sine of the opposite angle, that is sine 60 degree, will be equal to 120 divided by sine alpha. And from here you will get alpha as 69 degrees. Okay, so this will be 69, again this will come out to be 21. So the direction of your resultant would be 21 degrees south of east. So this question can also be done by parallelogram law. Okay, so you try it yourself. So here you have to find the resultant of a coplanar system of forces. Okay, so these are four forces which are coplanar. Okay, so their magnitude as well as their direction with certain axis is also given. Okay, so let's solve this. Okay, so first of all let's draw these forces on an xy plane and then we'll find the resultant of these forces. Okay, so we take x and y axis. All right, now these angles which are given to us, let these forces make these angles with the x axis. Okay, so we draw the first force. First force is 26 newton. All right, and it has angle 10 degree with the x axis. Okay, the second force is 39 newton and its angle is 114 degree, so it will come like this. This 39 newtons. The third force is 63 newton and it is acting at 183 degree. Okay. So this is 63 newtons. Okay. Fourth force is 57 newton and it is acting at 261 degrees. Okay, so it will be like this somewhat. Okay, so this is 57 newton. Okay, let us draw the angles with a different color. Okay, let me mark it again. So it is 10 degree. Okay, 39 newton force was acting at 114 degrees, 63 newton force was acting at 183 degrees, okay, and 57 newton force is acting at, this angle is 261 degrees, okay. Alright, so we have to find the resultant force of these coplanar vectors, okay. So these vectors are like this. Alright, so now if the resultant is given somewhat like this, alright, and it makes angle phi with the x axis, then you can resolve the resultant vector. Okay, this will be your resultant vector. All right, so its components will be, this direction would be Rx and this direction would be Ry. Okay, so these are the components of the resultant vector along x and y axis. This angle would be phi. Alright, so let's solve this. So we know that Rx will be equal to magnitude of r into cosine phi. Okay, so this component of the resultant will come due to the components of these four vectors in the x direction. Okay, so we can write the components of 26 newton force in the x direction is 26 cos 10 degrees. Okay, plus the component of 39 newton force will be 39 cos, the angle is 114 degrees. Okay, plus 63 cos 183 degrees, plus 57 cos 261 degrees. Okay, so we can calculate all this. So this comes out to be minus 62.1 newtons. Alright, okay. Similarly, Ry would be magnitude of r sin phi, which will be equal to the components of these four forces along the y-axis. So we can write magnitude of r sin phi will be equal to 26 sin 10 degrees. Okay, it will be similar to this, just replace the cos terms by sin terms, plus 39 sin 114 degrees, plus 63 sin 183 degrees, plus 57 sin 261 degrees. Alright, so this is it. So this all comes out to be 19.5 newtons. Alright, so we have obtained magnitude of r cos phi is equals to minus 62.1 and magnitude of r sin phi is equal to minus 19.5. okay, so squaring and adding these two equations will give us magnitude of r square equals to minus 62.1 square plus minus 19.5 square. So this will give us the magnitude of r is equal to 65 newtons. Alright, so now we calculate what is the angle phi. For that we divide the second equation with the first equation. So we'll get 10 phi will be equal to minus 19.5 divided by minus 62.1. As both the numerator and the denominator are negative, so phi is in the third quadrant. Okay, this will be your phi. Okay, so 10 phi is perpendicular upon base, so perpendicular is also negative and base is also negative. So this is our case. So we shouldn't just make it positive by removing the negative signs here, as if you will remove the negative signs, you won't be able to tell in which quadrant phi lies. Okay, so now we can tell that phi lies in the third quadrant. So phi will be given as 180 plus 17 degrees. Okay, that will be 197 degrees. Alright, so take care of these signs. Okay, they will tell you in which quadrant this angle lies. Alright, so in this question we have to calculate the rectangular components of a 100 newton force, which is shown like this. Okay, so the force vector makes angle 30 degree with the z-axis, and the projection of the F vector on the xy plane, which is given by OP here, so this makes angle 45 degree with the x-axis. Okay, now we have to find out what are the rectangular components of the force vector F. So the force vector can be written as fxi cap plus fy j cap plus fz k cap. Okay, now fx, fy and fz are the projections of this force vector F on x, y and z axis respectively. Okay, and fxi cap, this is the rectangular component of the force vector F in the x direction. Okay, similarly this is the rectangular component in the y direction and this is in the z direction. Okay, so we have to calculate the rectangular components. Okay, so we see that the projection of this F vector on the z axis is given by fz. Okay, now let's say that the projection of the F vector on the xy plane is given by fxy. Okay, This is just the notation I am using. Okay, so fxy is nothing but magnitude of OP vector. Okay, this is it. So fxy is representing the projection of the vector f on the xy plane. Okay, all right. So now if we project these onto the x-axis and y-axis, okay, these being 90, so this will be fx and this will be fy. All right, so now we calculate what are fx, fy and fz. Okay, so fz is very easy to calculate. This is nothing but the force vector f dot k cap. This will give you magnitude of f cos of the angle between the two, which is 30 degree. Okay, so this is fz. So this is 100, as the magnitude of the force is 100 newton into cos 30 is root 3 by 2. So this gives us 50 root 3 newtons. Okay, so the rectangular component in the z direction is fz k cap. Okay, this is equal to 50 root 3 k cap. Okay, newtons. So now we find what is fxy. Okay, fxy is nothing but the projection of force vector f on xy plane. Alright, so it is given by magnitude of the force vector f into cos of this angle. Okay, this angle is 60 degrees. So this will be cos 60 degree. This will be nothing but 100 into 1 by 2, which is 50. Alright, now we can write what is fx. Fx is nothing but fxy into cos of this angle, which is cos 45 degree. So this will be 50 by root 2. Okay, similarly fy will also be 50 by root 2, as this angle is also 45. Okay, so the rectangular component in the x direction will be fx I cap. This will be 50 by root 2 I cap, and rectangular component in y direction will be fy into j cap. It will be 50 by root 2 j cap. Now we have found out what are the rectangular components of the force vector f. Okay, we can now also write what is the force vector f if we want. So this will be 50 by root 2 I cap plus j cap plus this is 50 root 3 k cap newtons. Okay, so this will be your force vector. Okay, so let's move on to our next problem. So here we have been given the magnitude of three forces and they are said to act at a point with their line of action along the three diagonals of the three surfaces of a cube with a corner at that point. Okay, so what it simply means is that these three forces act along the diagonals of the three surfaces which make a corner. Okay, and the line of action passes through that corner only. Okay, so let that corner be the origin O. So we can draw the forces like this. Let this force be FA vector. Let this force be FB vector. And let this force be FC vector. The magnitude of these three forces are also given to us. So the magnitude of FA vector is given as F. Magnitude of FB vector is 2F. And magnitude of FC vector is 3F. So now we have been asked what is the net force and what is its magnitude. Okay, so let's solve it. So the net force F net is given by FA vector plus FB vector plus FC vector. Okay, so now we have to calculate these forces individually one by one. So FA vector is nothing but magnitude of FA vector times the unit vector in the direction of FA. Okay, so we have to calculate what is the unit vector in this direction. Okay, so first of all, let the sides of the cube be of unit length. Okay, so if this cube has sides of unit length, then you can say that the coordinates of point A are 1, 1, 0, and the coordinates of point B are 1, 0, 1, and the coordinates of point C are 0, 1, 1. Alright, so this is FA vector is equals to mod of FA vector into the unit vector. Okay, so the unit vector in the direction of FA is nothing but OA vector divided by magnitude of OA. Alright, so FA has been given to us, it is nothing but F. OA vector is I cap plus J cap. Okay, and its magnitude is nothing but 1 square plus 1 square, that is root 2. Alright, so similarly FB vector is nothing but FB vector's mod into OB divided by magnitude of OB. This is nothing but 2F. OB is I cap plus K cap. Once again, it is divided by root 2. Okay. Similarly, FC can also be calculated . It is given as FC, the mod of FC is 3F. Alright, and OC is J cap plus K cap. Alright, now we add these forces to get this is FC vector. So now we add these forces to get F net. Alright. Let us now calculate F net. So F net is given by FA vector plus FB vector plus FC vector. So now this can be written as F by root 2 is common in all three. And inside we get I cap plus J cap plus twice I cap plus K cap plus thrice J cap plus K cap. Okay. So this gives us F by root 2. You have 3 I cap plus 4 J cap plus 5 K cap. Okay. So this is your F net. Okay. The magnitude of F net is given by F by root 2 into under root 3 square plus 4 square plus 5 square. Okay, so this is 9 plus 16, 25, and 5 square is again 25. So this is root 50. So root 50 divided by root 2 will give us root 25. So this will be 5f. Alright. So this is your final answer. So this question says that there is a rectangular room of length 5 meters and width and the height of the room are both 4 meters. So there is a fly at the floor of this room right at the center. Okay. And this fly is flying towards the corner of the room. Alright. So the fly has a speed of 0.5 meter per second. Okay. So you have to tell that what is the velocity vector of the fly. Okay. And you have to express it like vxi cap plus vyj cap plus vz k cap. Okay. So let's do it. Alright. So let's name these points first. So let this point be P, this point be R. Right. So the length of the room is given as 5 meter. So we take this as 5 meters. Okay. And this as 4 meters. Okay. Again, this is 4 meters. Alright, so now we know the coordinates of the point P. So P is right at the center of the floor of the room. Okay, so the coordinates will be 2.5, 2, 0. Okay, and the coordinates of point R will be, R is in the yz plane, so x will be 0 and y will be 4. Z will be also 4. Okay, so these are the coordinates of the points P and R. Okay, now let us solve the problem. Alright, so the velocity vector of the fly is nothing but magnitude of the velocity vector of fly into the unit vector in the direction of the fly's flight. Okay, so that will be given by vector PR. Okay, divided by magnitude of vector PR. So this will be the unit vector in the direction of fly's flight. So now we have to find what is PR vector. Okay, so we know that this is radius vector of point R, this is the radius vector of point P. Okay, so this will be radius vector of R with respect to P. So PR is nothing but radius vector of R with respect to P. And it will be according to the triangle of RR minus RP. So what is RR? 0 I cap plus 4 J cap plus 4 K cap minus RP is given by 2.5 I cap plus 2 J cap plus 0 K cap. Okay. So this will be minus 2.5 I cap plus 2 J cap plus 4 K cap. Okay. So this will be your PR vector. Alright. So the unit vector in the direction of vector PR is given by PR vector divided by magnitude of PR vector. So this is nothing but 1 upon the magnitude of PR vector will be under root minus 2.5 square plus 2 square plus 4 square, okay, into what is the PR vector? Minus 2.5 I plus 2j plus 4k. So let's continue here. So PR vector divided by magnitude of vector PR is equal to, so this comes out to be under root 26.5 into this okay. So the velocity of the fly can be easily written as the magnitude of the velocity of the fly is given as 0.5 meter per second, this 0.5 into the unit vector in the direction of PR, okay, there is nothing but this, so it will be under root 26.5 minus 2.5 I cap plus 2 j cap plus 4 k cap, okay. So now you solve it and you'll get the answer. I have the answer with me as minus 0.24 I cap plus 0.196 j cap plus 0.392 k cap. Okay, so just check it if this is correct or not. Okay, so this is your answer. All right.